Today, I will discuss about geospatial data mining. Geospatial data is also known as geographical data or geodatabase. There are three types of geospatial data. One is raster data, second one is vector data, third one is the attribute data that we can get from a tabular form, that also known as tabular data. Raster data represented through a digital image. What are the examples of raster data? That is satellite image, scan map, photographs, and vector data. Vector data representing the location and shape of geographical feature through geometric shapes like point, line, polygon. Attribute data is a tabular data like as census data, state and country data, agricultural and economic data. There are several raster data types. We can categorize those in different way. Here, I have tried to make some category about the raster data. There are four categories like discrete raster data, continuous raster data, thematic raster data, spectral raster data, and another one is the picture raster data. What is discrete raster data? That is the population density map. Continuous raster data, that is the satellite data of temperature, satellite data, graded data of rainfall. Thematic raster data, that is the coral plate is an example of thematic raster data. And then spectral raster data, raw raster data of ELISA 3 and the satellite image, those are the spectral raster data. And the last one is the picture raster data, that is the georeference picture of the data. Now, another raster data type, that is the raster base map, that is orthophoto from the aerial photograph, satellite imagery, scan map or photograph, and surface raster like elevation map, digital elevation model map, thematic raster like thematic land use map and land cover map, raster as attribute feature like digital photograph, scanned image, scan drawing, etc. I put some example of raster data type, that is panchromatic data. That is the example of panchromatic data is IconoSpan, Spot, HRVPan. Example of multi-spectral data, Landsat, Spot, HRVXS, Iconos, MS, LIS. Hyperspectral data, that is the Hyperion, and microwave data, that is the SAR. Now, I can put some source of raster data. That is the most popular USGS Earth Explorer, that is the one of the important source of raster data. From this website, you can get the multispectral data like Landsat, LIS, elevation data like ASTAR, SRTM, hyperspectral data like Hyperion. Another important raster data hub, that is the Sentinel Open Access Hub. We can get from here Sentinel 1, Sentinel 2, that is very useful. NASA Earth Data, NOAA Data Access Viewer, Digital Globe Open Data Program are also is important raster data sources. You can get raster data from NASA Worldview, NASA Plus, Geo Aerospace Defense, National Institute of Space Research, Bhuvan India Geoportal Platform by ISRO, JAXA's Global Alert Studio World, NOAA Digital Coast, Vito Vision, UNAVOCO, Satellite Land Cover Facility, etc. Now, we can go through different websites that is very useful for raster data analysis, a raster data source. That is the ALOS. ALOS, Global Digital Surface Model. It is very popular for the ALOS dam. Now the open topography, that is popular for high resolution topographical data tool. We can get lot of high resolution data, surface data from this website. Mars orbital laser altimeter, that's is called MOLA. Here we can get the imagery, satellite imagery, imagery hybrid, navigation map, then street map, terrain with levels, topographic world map, etc. United States Interagency Elevation Inventory, we can get imagery land surface, imagery of land surface, ocean, street from this website. This is very important, the source of data, that is NOAA Digital Coast. We can get various data like land cover data, elevation data, different type multispectral image from NOAA Digital Coast websites. And that is also very popular for the source of lead LiDAR data of LiDAR data for analysis. NEON data portal is also an important raster data source, raster data portal that you can get different ecosystem and ecological observations, data related ecological observation, ecosystems and changing the and their changing characteristics, everything in the surface raster, raster format you can get from the websites. That is the another important, that is LiDAR cloud. You can get LiDAR data from this website. It is a remote access of LiDAR data and raster data also. NASA Earth Observation, that is NEO. We can get different surface information of land surface temperature, then temperature anomaly, false color MODIS, then average land surface temperature, albedo, Antarctica elevation, everything you can get from this website. That is also important for raster data, that is Copernicus Open Access Hub. We can get from here that ESS website, the Sentinel data, that is special for Sentinel data. Then Global Map Data Archive. From Global Map Data Archive, we can get global map metadata, different specification, available data set, natural regions, elevation data, land cover data, vegetation patterns, tree cover patterns, etc. Environmental Data Explorer is also one of the important, source of raster data. We can get a live information, a different types of information, and also live, the marine aquaculture productions, protected areas, how many fishes has been catch. Yes, a Sentinel online hub, we can get Sentinel data 1 and 2 from this website. Now, that is very popular, USGS GLOMIS. Different types of multispectral data, hyperspectral data, that is called HiPrime, and elevation data, ASTER, SRTM, we can get from this website. That is USGS Earth Explorer, most popular one. We can get different types of multispectral data, hyperspectral data, and then elevation data from here. Natural Earth Data. We can get different scale cultural physical raster images, cultural physical images of raster data in different scale from this website. That is very crucial and important for Indian researcher. That is the Indian Geoportal, Indian ISRO Geoportal, that is called Bhubo. We can get ISRO data, ISRO satellite data like LIST-3, CATODEM, etc. from here for the whole country. Now the climate data guide. Most important, that is TRMM data. TRMM stands for Tropical Rainfall Measuring Machine. We can get the whole world precipitation data as surface raster in a gridded format. That is a customized rainfall information. That is operated by the Indian Meteorological Department. You can get station-wise rainfall All over India, and you can get, you can also get this, I mean, district wise rainfall and spatial analysis of those rainfall. CHRS data. CHRS, from this website, you can get the all over rainfall daily, monthly, seasonally, and yearly from 2003 for the whole world as a surface raster. That is Survey of India Open Series map. Survey of India has been published various maps of the Indian subcontinent. This map we can get from here through this website, that is the SOI, that is Survey of India Open Series map. And that is the important concern of our hydrological research, that is the Central Water Commission portal. We can get different types of maps, different types of data, hydrological data, different types of measurement, dam condition, everything from the Central Water Commission portal, that is maintained by the Central Water Commission, empowered by the Ministry of Jal Shakti, Department of Water Resources, Rivers Development and Ganga Rejuvenation. Now, the Geological Survey of India map series. The publication in the form of maps and reports and everything published by the Geological Survey of India, we can get from here. We need to put our queries and as per our requirement, then and go to the search option. Then we will get our required maps and information from this website. That is the Anthropological Survey of India website. We can get different types of maps, data, related anthropology of India, anthropological, I mean, attributes of India from this website. That is NBSS LUP web portal, National Bureau of Soil Survey and Land Use Planning. Different types of land use map, different types of soil map in micro and meso scale, micro and macro scale on all over India, and report has been published by NBSS LUP. We can get from this website. Now, I will discuss about the vector data type. We are also known that there are three types of vector data. There is point, line and polygon. Point means that is a location data, and another one is a GPS data. Line means street map, railway network map, and it can be a river network map, and a polygon, area of geological aspect, that is the forest, agricultural land, etc., administrative boundary, river basin, watershed. Those are the example of the polygon vector data. ArcGIS Hub is one of the important source of vector data. We can get different types of vector data from this website. Now, OpenStreetMap. You can get the street map and or the street vector of India and all over the world from this website, that is called OpenStreetMap. We can get different types of vector in different format from this website, that is called Geo Network. Indian watershed, that is very crucial, I mean, website. Now we can get river basin boundary. We can get different types of basin information in vector format from this website. This is also important website. We can get different types of, I mean, different basin boundary and watershed boundary from this website. The World Bank Data Catalog. The World Bank Data Catalog is popular for the major river basin of the world. We can get different major basin vector from this website. That is GeoPortal. Different types of vector data we can get from this website. Now the attribute data. What are the attribute data? Attribute data may be census data, that may be rainfall data, forest data, statistical handbook, annual flood report, hydrological data. socio-economic data and application on center, application center. That is one of the important source of socio-economic data, that is the attribute data of all over the world. IMPAS data is also an important source of integrated population and environmental data. GPS visualizer is popular for get different types of GPS data. You can also use this website for GPS data management. Free maps from Garmin brand GPS device. You can get free maps from this website that is Garmin based. Easy GPS, our GPS data can be manipulated and can be managed from this website, and I can also get some GPS point track from this website. Export GPS data also is useful, export or download map from a map for use for the further attribute data, vector data. That is one important attribute data source, that is the Indian Water Portal. From this website, we can get state-wise and district-wise rainfall, rainfall temperature, relative humidity, everything that is the climate data from 19001 to 2002. It is the source of district-wise rainfall data of India. We can get rainfall in a monthly, daily, and yearly pattern from this website for every district of India. That is the Census of India website, office of the Registrar General of Census Commissioner of India. That is maintained by the Ministry of Home Affairs, Government of India. We can get different census report, city block wise, primary census after, everything for different states and different district of India. That is another important data source, that is a data gobbing. We can get different types of attribute data from this website. We can get different types of statistical data from the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation website, that is the Statistical Yearbook of India. Here is available Statistical Yearbook India's ranges from 2011 to 2018. Irrigation and Water Resources Department, maintained by the Government of India, we can get different types of hydrological data, flood warning system data, watershed data of West Bengal from this website. Global Energy Statistics Yearbook. Global Energy Statistics Yearbook is popular for whole world basis energy statistical data. This is one of the important website of West Bengal government, that is the Bengal Sajet Ahead Egiye Cholo Egiye Bangla website. We can get different types of information data related to West Bengal government from this website. That website, it is maintained by the Department of Planning and Statistics, Government of West Bengal. It is popular for different types of agriculture statistics. We can get annual report, we can get district human development report, district statistical handbook, economic census, economic review, socioeconomic survey, state economy, statistical abstract, statistical handbook from this website. That is the Bharat map. Bharat map is one of the important source of different thematic and different GIS layer and the location map of India. That is the Shodh Ganga. That is the important source of different, the published thesis of in different Indian university. We can get different types of thesis from here, and we can also get the different types of data maps from those thesis that is already uploaded in the Shodh Ganga website. That's all For my side, logs is your. So now your terms, search for more, explore more.